This video update brought to you by RaceDayScore.com. Daily fantasy NHRA drag racing.
We're joined at Media Center by number one qualifier in Funny Car, current number one qualifier in Funny Car, Robert Height, 3.942 seconds at 322.19 miles per hour. He had one number one qualifying position last year and 47 in his career. Robert, we kind of talked a little bit about on Wednesday, but how important is it to come out here first pass and get a good number going into the weekend?
That's really the way every weekend plays out. You know, if you don't get down the track the first run, you're just behind the eight ball all weekend long. And, you know, it's kind of funny. My crew chief, Mike Neff, he usually plays it pretty smart the first run and just makes a baseline run, then tries to get after it in the evening when it cools off. But, you know, I think the whole Funny Car ball game has changed in the last year. You know, you've got to be aggressive. If you look at last year, this 94 I just ran would have been a national record at this racetrack. And we did it on a pretty hot racetrack the first session. So Funny Car racing has changed. And, you know, as drivers, tuners, teams, we've got to adapt to that. And we've got to be more aggressive. You saw what it took to win the championship at the end of the year. Those guys were running 80s. And, you know, everybody at JFR, we didn't like that. You know, we went into the last two races of the season not in it with even a chance to win the championship. And that's uncharted territory. So motivated us. We've worked hard. Had a great test session out in Phoenix a week ago, and came right in here and obviously showed it's not a fluke with Courtney and I number one and number two.
I guess testing in your case was it doesn't matter how you start, it's how you finish, right?
Yeah, exactly. We went to testing with a real good game plan, and Mike Neff really looked at where we were getting beat last year, and it was early in the run, first 100 feet. And so went in there, and we started really knocking 60-foot times off really good, but at 100 feet, it would smoke the tires. But he didn't change his game plan. He stayed on course and figured out how to get through that area at a second into the run and without sacrificing the 60-foot time. And we just put it all together, and we started running 80s. And once it went, it was easy. And he was pretty pumped. He says, what we learned here is really going to help us at Pomona. Pomona's a tricky track, can be early, and what we learned is going to pay dividends. So to come out here and run 94 the first run, I'm pretty impressed with these guys, my whole team, and you know, not a better place to do it than right in front of your sponsors, the Auto Club.
You have pretty good mojo at this track, so did you think that even if you weren't hitting it at Phoenix, you said, oh, it's going to be all right when we get to Pomona?
We knew that we could always go back to what we did in the fall. We didn't run terrible, but we weren't where we needed to be. We weren't competitive with the Beckmans and Worshams. We just weren't there. So got to be aggressive, and I'm proud of his game plan so far. And he was trying to get after it right there. He was really, you know, the track cooled down a good almost 15 degrees the second run, and no one ran quicker than we did. We were trying, but it didn't go. So we've got to be aggressive every run.
How difficult has the laid-back headers made these cars to drive?
They're more challenging, but it's more fun. It's got the wheels in the air, you know, it's light on the front end, and it's a handful to drive, but it is so much fun when it goes down the track. And I mean, you can make a run where you're all over the groove, inside, outside, and you look up there when you pull the chutes and you see a 394 pop up. That's a lot of fun. It's not boring anymore, I can tell you that.
What are the certain changes that you think that you've made this year to have a good testing and a good first run?
Like I said, it's early numbers, trying to really get after it early. And, you know, sometimes you're gonna smoke the tires at the head of the throttle. If you're not pushing it, you're never going to smoke the tires. But to get results in a 60-foot time, which is very, very important. Once you get, if you don't get a good 60-foot time, you can never gain that up. There is no way to get it back. There's just not enough available traction out there. So it's hitting it hard early and being more aggressive.
And how's your mindset after having a good first run?
Oh, I'm excited, especially, you know, testing and then coming into here. You know, now it's not a fluke, and we have to improve every day. I'm excited about it. Also excited about this new program that the Auto Club's come out with. You know, this being an election year, they're pitting Joey Logano and I in a campaign called Drags or Checkered Flags, and had a chance to do some videoing and filming with Joey Logano over the winter, and it's going to pit the drag racing versus the NASCAR. The fans are going to get to see a lot of cool videos and us back and forth bantering, and you know, fans are going to get to vote, and then at the end of the year we're going to have a little debate. So I think it's going to be fun for the fans to get involved with, and very fortunate to have a group like the Auto Club on board. This is a 5-year deal we're starting right now in January, so it's pretty nice to have you know, security, and especially today. It's tough. And also, I tell you, I'm excited about Fox Sports. Never ever have I seen an off season with so many news clips and positive energy. It's just it's been a great off season, and I'm glad it's finally here.
Robert, with the Joey Logano deal, will you bring up the famous line, if you're going, if you're turning left, you're going too slow?
Well, there's a video that actually kind of shows this dog going in circles, chasing its tail, and that's on my side, obviously. We haven't seen the ones yet that they're bashing the drag racers, so anyway, it's been a lot of fun so far.
How do you like this cross-racing between, okay, we had Dario and Graham, of course Graham's married to Courtney, so he's always here, but now Dario is here today. And then you have the deal with Logano, so it's nice to see all the different types of motorsports interacting.
It is. You know, I'm a fan of all motorsports. In fact, I'm going to the Daytona 500 next weekend. I've never been. I'm so excited. Going to go on Thursday, spend a lot of time with Chevrolet, and just take in the whole experience. And, you know, I've heard a lot of people talk fun things about Daytona. So hopefully I'm going to take a video camera and do some videoing and just my experience at Daytona.
That's a great event. Yeah, you'll love it.
Louis, anything?
No, I just...
Are you going to vote for me, Louie?
Well, I don't know. I mean,
look, this picture is a little bit pale there.
And where I live, the guys that run, you know, pay.
All right.